personally, whatever we do, I love things that are user-friendly. And I'm the same way you were, I mean, it's hard to believe that, I've been in business for 31 years, and, you know, computers were completely foreign, and I was 10 when I started my business.
Yeah.
When you went to work for the county, I remember that, yeah. So, everything in my organization now, you know, back in our shop, you know, our alignment machines and all that stuff, you know, there's lasers, but everything runs off a computer, our office runs off a computer, our warehouse system, that's all computerized, and even though I kicked and fought against it, man, I realized, man, this is just so easy. When I came on council 5 years ago, we were doing everything, and Miss Debbie spent this arduous task every month putting this big giant notebook together, and I would take this thing home, and really what put an end to it to me was the queen of the Culbreth household. She just got terribly upset about all this paper stacked up in the house, and she said, you're gonna have to find somewhere to get this stuff. You're gonna have to take your office, get it out of the house. And even though all of us didn't go to the computers, but, you know, I feel like that having everything there at my laptop, I mean, I don't have to go back. If I wanna know something, you know, that we did 6 meetings ago, I've got it right there. I don't have to go back and dig out this big ream of paper. And the other part I like too, we're not killing near as many trees.
What is the biggest problem? And again, in discussions with all three of you, it seemed, again, with those three departments, registered management, delinquent tax, and registered deeds, those three departments that we were initially talking about, I mean, what can we do, you know, to help y'all and those departments the quickest? I mean, is this system, you know, Judge, that this lawyer talked about, would that hit?
Well, that would not solve my problem with case management. That's a totally separate issue.
That would be in registered deeds office.
Now, eventually, when we get to electronic filing, but I think we would have to have approval from Supreme Court Administration before we go to electronic filing. I don't think we could do it on our own. I could be wrong, but that would be something I'd want to broach with court administration before I went into that.
Well, even if it's not public, it's there electronically. I think the best thing to do is get IT involved. Have them sit down and talk with us about it, because RMC needs equipment, and I think the problem is equipment and software. I mean, for every department, that's the issue. We get feedback from them on what's the best way. What's the best equipment? What's the best software? Research that and go with it, and then not let it drop off.
Yeah.
Follow through with it and make it happen.
All right, so that would help.
We've got to have
deeds office.
Exactly. Well, we've got to have a case management system so that we can, once we get these records scanned, you can't just put them out in cyberspace and not be able to retrieve them. So the case management system is what we began working on.
And that's for your two departments.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. All
right. And you know, that's very crucial. When we brought the scanning in-house, we did not realize that we don't have a good in-house case management system to retrieve those records.
And we have, how many presentations we set through? I mean, it's...
Have you seen any that you liked?
Yeah.
Both of you liked? Well, why haven't we gotten it? I mean, y'all are the ones that have to run it.
It's been a slow process, and I think, in IT's defense, I think they're trying to find something that will not just work for the clerk or just work for probate or just work for auditor. They want it to work for everybody in the county. So when we make this investment, it's countywide and not departmental, because a lot of the things we've done over the last 37 years I've been here has been department by department, and, you know, it's like you say, we're territorial. My department, I run this, and we don't get into everybody else's business, and they don't communicate with each other.
But this review has been going on for years. This is the one you're talking about, process?
Well, ever since we brought scanning in-house, which was July of last year.
So it's been a year. And that's too long.
But we started meeting before July,
All right, now the scanning thing. And I think for the registered deeds office to do what this, you know, the Greer lawyer said, what you recommend, and y'all think it would be a big help for that department.
Absolutely.
We ought to quickly investigate that and get on it and not let any more grass grow. Then this other part, let's get them moving on with IT, it's come up with a system that does work, you know. How about the scanning stuff that you mentioned earlier, Judge? I mean, months ago when we were talking, that when we were taking this stuff out a year or two ago, how we impacted yours, what do we need to help you?
Well, I just wanted to ensure that there would be people in the records management department to physically do my scanning. Because two delinquent tax workers or three were actually doing my scanning. I don't understand why they were doing it under delinquent tax rather than under records management.
Why aren't you doing your own scanning? Why don't we have people for you? You can't do that?
Well, let's put it this way. I haven't had an employee increase in 11 years.
Yeah, but if
I'm out of space. Yeah. My employees can't do what they need to be doing now. Some of these attorneys will tell you it's taken 6 or 8 months to get a closed file out of our office. It's not because we're not being diligent. It's just because we're overrun with work.
Yeah.
We can't do any more than we're doing.
So this system that we came up with, putting it in records management, they were supposed to do it for everybody?
Well, you know, years ago, when we had an in-house record management, it truly was the records management department. And when we outsourced it in 2000, I thought we were taking a step backwards then. Because we did everything in-house, and it was between the two buildings, and there wasn't this, well, I can't get a file because you could go over here and look at it. You couldn't see it in my office. So we were managing it ourselves in-house, and when the first budget crunch hit in 2000, they did away with all the record management people who were actually microfilming at that time the documents. And I don't necessarily need to have to add to my staff to try to do all this scanning.
Yeah.
Because you're talking about reams and reams and reams of paperwork.
So it is better to have it.
Well, with the folks that I do have scanning, they're scanning, but it's taking time away from other duties, which now, and we have a situation where someone is out, they're having to stay after hours to really get that day's work caught up because they have to sit there. Well, first of all, we don't have enough scanners if they were going to do it themselves. Because they have to wait till someone gets off the scanner and then go and sit and do it, and then follow through on all of that. It is time consuming.
And this trim, is that just record management there?
Yes.
So our records management department is doing the scanning.
Right. Well, but my information was the persons who were doing the scanning in records management were paid through delinquent tax that y'all had just cut that $300,000 from.
Yeah.
And that would take my workers away.
Yeah.
So I was very concerned that it doesn't come back to me.
Yeah.
Because I don't have the people nor the space to do it.
We put that money based on what,
right.
Again, your
right.
feedback, all three of y'all, we put that money back in.
Because I thought our scanning was fixing to come to a grinding halt.
Yeah, and that was important to hear because I didn't know, you know, what had happened a couple
right.
of years ago that, you know, it was moved around.
Well, nobody's scanning the clerks. Well,
and
other than the
years.
One part-time person, well, until y'all gave me that part-time position, she does it Monday through, and I have an intern who would volunteer for free, trying to pay us money. She's a Clemson grad, and she knows it front, back, and all the way around. She has come in, and they have done probably in the last 2 months, they've done work that probably is worth a half a year. I mean, because they are just not really taking breaks and just going through. But that's all I have. And outside of before Amy was hired, there was nobody. So nothing is technically being scanned.
We've got a whole department called records management.
Mm-hmm.
Don't we have
mm-hmm.
six people in it? I can't see their budget right now, but I thought it was four people. I mean, what are they doing? I mean, I don't need to, yeah. But they're supposed to be doing this. And you're saying we got a couple people from delinquent tax over to help out.
I know the
yeah,
fellow.
There are at least three or four temps in that budget.
And he's a temp. There's one. There's
She's been
one
a temp for 7 years?
Yeah. Who is a temp that is doing my scanning because when he's on vacation, it stops for a week.
Yeah. Well, that's unacceptable.
It
mean,
is.
And is
she,
that, I mean, is that
and
part
he's,
of
he's
our corrective
temp.
Action that we
right.
need to be taking?
Right.
We
exactly.
need a couple.
We need to get the right people in the right departments
right.
permanently.
And these people that would be doing the scanning, I mean, they would work for the unique body instead of
mm-hmm.
Sharon's office or your office.
Exactly.
I mean,
kind
okay.
Right.
And that's how y'all would like it.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
how I like
do
it.
You have, y'all have to have any particular skills for scanning? I mean, I do scanning in my mm-hmm. job. That's basically.
I've interviewed a couple of people who had that background. Now, the young lady that I hired as part-time used to create websites and has an IT background. I think she knows a lot more than a lot of other people that I know who supposedly that's their job. I mean, she has found She's found other companies to talk with for software, and that's how we were able to get them in to do these presentations. She was the person who found the scanners that will take, that will film, scan the microfilm. I mean, she does a wonderful job, and I went over and met with her and Karen. Diane was off, but they have some great ideas. It just, they don't have enough staff over there, and they need to be involved and progress.
Well, I'm just asking if they get, I mean, can anybody do the scanning? I mean, that's my question. I mean, does it have to be somebody that's
building inspectors, for instance? I mean, when we're not, we don't have a lot of buildings going on. I mean, can you pull people in and train them to scan and do stuff to help out?
Or is it
too
specialized or whatever?
I think you would need to know your way around a computer. I have sat and watched them and tried to do it and was decently successful. But I mean, when you have a problem and you have to stop, I mean,
right.
You want somebody who's knowledgeable to keep fix that problem and move on versus waiting for IT to come to help you out. So I think they need to have a specialized.
I'm going to ask a rudimentary question about this. Now, who is managing the records manager?
Me on the clerk's side, but I don't know who else on the other side. I mean,
today,
I mean, is that part of the problem?
Today, since the reorganization happened with the budget adoption and Sharon's new function, then Don Arnold is currently the interim director
of delinquent tax.
And he's the person who the records management folks report to.
Okay. And I didn't know that.
Okay, I didn't
know that. And I asked Don if he wanted to sit in with us today. But,
so he's running both departments.
I thought we'd taken. Last year, we took Steve Ford out from being over records management and register of deeds and just over delinquent tax. So you kept him over records management and
delinquent tax and just took out the register of deeds part. Yes, sir.
He's been stepping in where he could since he was on the first to help records management move on.
Everybody got real quiet all of a sudden. We're going to move forward. And we are going to get out here at 1 o'clock. And I think we're really making some progress here. And I guess I'm going to speed things up a little bit and maybe move forward and summarize a few of the things that we see the need here. First of all, go back, and the way I see it, and anybody chime in as they feel needed. We're going to have equipment and software updates. That's going to be the first thing, or that's one of the priorities on the agenda. One of the second things I see from talking with you guys, and I do appreciate your input, and this is what we need. You're the guys that do the work where the rubber meets the road. We need more personnel to do the scanning. Is that the consensus of the group?
I think so.
Yeah. And we feel like that the personnel needed needs to be a cooperative group for all departments. And I know we have Don as a quote interim supervisor at this point. I think we need to be looking at both permanent supervision. However, I mean, it may end up one of you guys may be the supervisor. And that's just food for thought for right now. I'm looking at, I think those are going to be two things that we need to get accomplished fairly quickly. One of the things that I'd like to see